trying something different to what I usually do. And who doesn't love weird stories, right? This is a story about Robert the doll. It's fair to say that Key West, Florida is well known. Of Robert the Doll. Eugene Otto and the elements of voodoo set to link the two together. Although Robert seems to be nothing but a rather careworn doll, dressed in a sailor suit, holding a toy dog, covered in small marks that seem to appear a little too like scars, with small beady eyes and a smirk on his face. Many agree that he is directly responsible for a veritable bounty of woe. Robert has over the years been accused of causing accidents, relationship breakdown, divorce, disease, and much, much more. So where did Robert the doll come from? Although Robert's origins are disputed, this is one of those stories that gets passed around from family member to family member within the state. It's generally thought that Robert was given to Otto as a present from his grandfather following a trip to Germany. After some investigation by the Fort West Martello Museum, where Robert resides today, it's now thought that the doll was never actually intended to be a doll. It's thought to be made by Stife and perhaps to have manufactured as part of the clown or just a display. That outfit that he's wearing is thought to be Otto's own. And if you're wondering where Robert got his name, from Eugene. That's right, Eugene's full name is Robert Eugene Otto. And soon the doll ended up with the name Robert, while Otto was simply referred to by his middle name. Another story about Robert the Haunted Doll and his origins describes the Otto family's mistreatment of their servants and maids. The family lived in a large mansion house that still stands today. Stands at the corner of Simonton and Eaton. The size of the house meant that the family needed help. One maid was apparently caught using voodoo and was quickly fired. But before she left, she gave Robert to Eugene. Robert was cursed. She had used some of the voodoo that she'd been fired for on the doll to bring fear and discomfort to the family. Robert the Haunted Doll is well known for being more than a little spooky. But in the beginning, things seemed a little bit more innocent. Like any other childhood friendship between a boy and his doll. Seen without his beady-eyed companion in tow. Eugene was often heard whispering to Robert, which was entirely normal. It was only when a deep voice was heard answering back to Eugene that things started to get a little bit strange. was said to have somewhat of a hold over Eugene, and loud, violent commotions could be heard coming from Eugene's bedroom on an almost nightly basis. Furniture could often be found overturned. Toys of Eugene's were often found ripped apart. And when the Otto family entered Eugene's room, he was found huddled on his bed, petrified. When asked what had happened, he only ever had one response. Robert did it. Stories of servants arrived and promptly quit their jobs in quick succession, and it's also claimed that the aunt that banished Robert to the attic passed away the same night that he was put there. Despite his banishment, the Otto family was said to hear Robert the doll moving frequently around the upstairs portion of the house, with his footsteps said to echo throughout areas of the property that were completely empty. He was even said to giggle in the middle of the night. Despite all of this, and despite his obvious fear of Robert as a child, Eugene kept Robert as he grew up and into an adult. Artist and later married, and kept Eugene propped up in a window of his house. School children and almost anyone walking past the property would say that they often saw the doll disappear from sight before appearing again before their eyes. Many people avoided the house entirely so that they could avoid Robert. Eugene's wife was said to detest Robert and supposedly banished him to the attic. Naturally, he didn't take particularly kindly to this, and so Robert, the haunted doll, once more placed demands on Eugene, requesting the turret room of the house because he wanted a room with a view of the street. Spent all of his time in the turret room with Robert, painting and talking to his doll until his death in 1974. The story of Robert Eugene Otto doesn't end there. The Robert doll story continues well past Eugene's passing, and the legend continues even to this day. She had left him. Visitors to her new home didn't like Robert and found that he'd appear and disappear at will. She and her visitors also claim that the already creepy expression on Robert's face appeared to change when anyone discussed Eugene in a negative way. social media accounts, and a Robert replica doll is being sold. If we're to believe anything about voodoo, perhaps with the increased exposure of Robert, plus replicas of him being sold, the increased bad luck of visitors to the museum is simply due to the curse being spread. Of recent